Hey Imran, can you stand up on the pedals while you're sitting? Of course I can. No, you can't. Yes, I can. Chalo karke dikhao. Next thing you know, it was very drafty and windy. And when he ran, that guy was really angry.
So there were no retakes?
No, I don't think so. No, he started crying after the security. It's not drama, kya isme? Actually, the shock was your idea. Interesting. Now the truth comes out.
He was getting you ready for Delhi Bedi. Imran, what are your memories of that shoot?
It was honestly just a whole lot of fun. We never really talked about, you know, your acting, you have to do this. There was never that kind of thing. Honestly, for me, it was an excuse to get out of school. There are a number of times I remember that I would be sitting in class and suddenly someone would come in and say, Imran, go to the principal's office. And I'm thinking, what have I done? I didn't do anything. I'd go there and I would see mom sitting over there kind of looking really serious. And I'd be told, listen, that there's a family emergency, you have to leave school. What's going on? What's happening? So as I was walking out, I was asking mom, what's going on? She's like, shh, don't say anything, just keep walking. We got into the car and she said, we're going to Mud Island, we're shooting. What? Yeah, Mud Island, chalo. So from, I was in Bobby's college at the time. So from Miami, we hopped in the car, we've driven all the way to Mud Island. I think that was actually the day we shot that last bit when I was hitting more my brother. But yeah, for me, it was just that. I was hanging out with Aamir Mamu, Mansur Mamu, mom was on the set all the time. So it was just all of us, my entire family, hanging out. Making a movie was kind of a family affair.
What was in that episode?
Yeah, actually, the four actors are the previous four actors.
That's the only shot left of them.
Yeah.
Powder falling on them.
There's Bunty Valia in there. There's Tony D'Souza, who's now our director. Vikram Razdan and Vishal Varma, they were four. We can do an alternate reunion with people who are left.
The cut that didn't make it.
But I have to ask, you know, when I watched the film again to prep for this, I'm that kind of person. I wanted you to go back to the losers and just gloat a little. But you were a better man than me. You just froze it on that. And why did you not allow us to just gloat? You know, just the fact that you won and the evil people lost. Yeah, right at the end.
I have to tell you this, that Aamir was insisting that we have a scene where they come up on the, we had the scene, but we were shooting it and Aamir at that time he used to think differently. So he wanted to, when the third guy comes and then Deepak comes and he steps up, and I'm going up, I'll just give him a little shove and walk up on the first thing. I said, Aamir, that's what the earlier Sanjay Lal would do. You've learned what it takes to win. So we had that shot, but we never kept it.
He's learned, but he's not lost a sense of humor.
Certainly not on the set. I mean, Kiran, you have stories of what he did to your braids, your hair.
Me? What did I do?
Yes, I mean, today all your poles are...
So, Yadi and Moya, I don't remember any of this here. You are making it up.
Yes, I mean, being a prankster, he is. I clearly remember when we were at Kodaikanal, the ground and the racing scenes, the entire cast was there, and there were a lot of chaos and masti and everything going on. And every time I was supposed to have this schoolgirl, choti's, yeah. And somehow every time Aamir would manage to go behind me and he would tie my ribbons so tight, and it would take good 15 minutes to go out of it, and everyone would be at home, especially Mansoor. Aamir, please, what is this? Every time you do this, I'm in musty mood. And this is how, I mean, Aamir would, and there's one more thing he would keep doing to everyone, I guess, the cup.
I don't like to tell that story. Because when I tell the story, then I can't do it on new people.
There's a whole new generation. He used to say, let me read your hand and spit on it and
His latest
posters
of
Dangal
are raising their hands.
Why do I spit on my heroine's hands? It's very important to know that. Jis heroine ke haath pe maine thooka hai, wo number one ho gayi. Isliye wo kya? Because it's my responsibility to do that.
But what about support? Support?
Sabke haath pe thooka hai maine. Sab number one.
Aamir, but supporting actor ke haath pe thooka hai, uska kya hua? Supporting actor ke haath pe thooka hai, uska kya hua?
It only works for heroines.
I must take a chance here and say for all of us here that, you know, they say that life is nothing but memories, later lives, wherever. And for all of us, this film has been the most memorable about all of the lot. I'm sure most of us will agree. I'm sure that it has been, you know, so many things. For this film, this has been something that I will never forget in my life for so many reasons. The memories that Mansoor had created for me and Jatin together while making this music was something that was so learning from there onwards in our career and so memorable. And I always feel and I say that Jojita was one film where I enjoyed working the most in many ways. And I miss Majur Saab and I miss my brother Jatin here today. And also let me tell you one more thing, that this film has been the most inspiring film for many of the directors who have later on have made some wonderful films. In fact, in one of my sessions, in just a session with Aditya Chopra, he said that when this film was in the screen, they were in college, both Karan Johar and Aditya Chopra. And obviously, they were young guys and writing something and doing whatever they were doing. And they said that when we will grow up and when we will make films, we will work with Jatin and Lalit. This music has been so inspiring for them. So I really, from my heart, thank Nasir Saab and Mansoor Saab for leading us making this music. Because I strongly feel, had Mansoor Saab had not been there, this music would have not been the way it came out to be. Because this was our very first music. We were very nice, very eager to do well, but there was we needed somebody really like a pillar behind us, because we went into a big group of musicians working who were looking a little down on us. Ki kaun ladke aa gaye hain, kya hai? But Mansoor backed us very, very nicely and said, no, you go ahead, you do whatever you have in mind, we'll see how it goes. And that gave us the strength, and that is what has made this music.
I used to take them jogging on the beach. We composed half of the music on the beach in Mandla. So because it's a sports center, right? Even the music directors have to run here.
Talking about Aamir thinking differently those days, there is a moment which I'd like to really share. It was a very crucial thing. I don't know, Mansoor, Aamir and me. It so happened that I was supposed to do the fight with Mamek the next day. Mansoor tells me to come to his room, and when I go to the room, Aamir is there. And we're discussing. Mansoor's question is that tomorrow Deepak is supposed to fight Mamek. I don't know if you guys remember this. Okay, it's a classic case. It's an amazing case. So I'm like, okay, so I was not prepared for what exactly Mansoor is getting at. So he says, now tomorrow Deepak is supposed to fight Mamek, so what do you think Deepak should happen? So I looked at Aamir, and Aamir was like, okay, So he says, Aamir, what do you think? So Aamir was very clear. He was like, see, Deepak is a villain. He is supposed to get beaten up. So Ansu looks at me. I said, Ansu, I don't agree with Aamir. Because my logic was different. If you beat me up here, then my race with Aamir was completely flat. Then everybody knows, if the brother's beaten me, then hero is going to beat me.
Chalu hai recording.
So, Ansu just went quiet. We were all quiet. He says, okay, fine. Go now, both of you. Ansu was always very, very clear, very curt, very, okay, for work is over, now you go. So, what was decided? What was exactly? So, Aamir said, but, no, I don't, you know, you should do films like Dil and all. Let's not talk about it. So, okay, you are both won. So that's how, the next day when I was doing the sequence, the whole scenario was entirely different. So it was like, you know, I remember this very clearly, that yeah, it was a different thinking that Aamir was going through.
I can vaguely remember that now. Because I always, you know, looked at Mamik's character as, you know, Jackie Shroff.
Yeah.
Oh, Jackie Shroff, who can't accept that? So my point was that, I don't want to feel that, you know, I want to feel that he was an elder brother, he could take care of himself. But because of some trickery, the three of you all beat him up.
Yeah.
That was my point.
Yeah, okay.
If you know what I meant to say.
Okay.
Because you usko tum log gira dete ho mountain se usko.
Haan.
But usse pehle, he should be getting the better of you. Was my point. Okay, he should be someone who I look up to and I feel care, what a hero you. And he's standing up to the three or four guys who attacked him. But it's because of the circumstances, no,
correct.
Cheating is not usko mar.
So I guess after 24 years, you got justification to be back. Once you never gave you that chance that night, that evening.
And
it would
be hard to be shoot traffic, ain't it? Ultimately, how was it? He falls over, but he falls over. He was over.
On the same lines, I mean, I'm just talking about Aamir's graciousness. I mean, he was a big actor at those times. And I believe what I remember is my character was written in, I think, at a much later date, I suppose, is what I remember. Maybe I'm wrong. But I remember Aamir telling me in Goli Canal that, Mami, ye film ka kuch bhi hoga. But your character will take off. And knowing that, so comfortably went through the film, so encouraging through the entire, you know, process of making it. And a great friend to have, I must thank you for that, for your friendship. And I've bothered you a lot also, sorry to you also.
It's been 24 years since the film released. Time since, I mean, Pooja, you've spoken about how you went to the theatre right after the film released, very different from what you looked in the film. I mean, Farah, you said it's the film that's changed your life. Do you find that that's the film you're most frequently remembered for?
Yes, I definitely feel so. Because the song Pehla Nasha especially has stood out so much in the career of Jatin Lalit that whenever we meet somebody, who's a music lover, will always speak about this song. And the singers who have sung this, they say that this is their life's best song. And I must give credit to Maju Saab the way he's put the song together. It's absolutely magical, and I think it just happens once in a lifetime. And that is one of the reasons why I've never tried to make this song or a song of this style again. Because I know it just happened.
You know, I have to say that till today, it's been 24 years, but every single time I'm invited to any function, it could be in Calcutta, it could be across India, it could be even internationally, at the moment when they ask me to come on stage, it's always Pehla Nasha that's playing as a theme song when I walk onto the stage. It's unbelievable. And the number of times the song has been played on the radio till date, the number of remixes that have come up about the song, even Sanam has done a wonderful rendition of it recently. It's amazing. The song has just gone from strength to strength. And I think the film is more popular today than it was back then. you know, it's really lived on people's minds and people's hearts, and it's just been fabulous. But I have to say, I think my most amusing part of shooting this film was the height difference between Aamir and me. Let's demonstrate, Aamir. And there was a scene, you know, the gold digger scene when, you know, I just slap him and I walk away and then he walks behind me. So generally, Aamir was very sweetly given this box he had to stand on. And he would do it really sweetly, you know, there was no ego attached. He was wonderful about it. He'd get on very matter-of-factly and do the scene with Dinika. And then in the scene, I slap him and walk away. So suddenly there's Aamir and he gets on the box. So there's Aamir and Aamir chasing me. So then he said, no, no, this isn't working. So then they had to build a ramp.
Pooja is never going to spit on your hand after this.
Okay, I'm going to send my daughter to him and I'm going to say, Alia, you have to go to meet Aamir uncle. He needs to spit on your hand.